Good morning students and welcome back to another video of magnetic effects of electric current. So in the previous video we studied about generator and AC generator, and the motor that we studied was DC motor. We know that there are two types of current, that is AC current and DC current, and I have said this before that in our house we use AC current, and this is a diagram from your textbook. This shows the connection in our house with how the different appliances are connected, and worldwide we use 220 volts as a standard potential difference for all the appliances. Now the benefits of using the same potential difference is that we have to use parallel resistance, and we know that in parallel resistance is one of the connection is broken, then the other connection still works. So you can use any appliance and the potential difference will be same for all. So if they are connected in series, then we will require different potential difference for different appliances, and we don't want that. So all the appliances are made in such a way that they require potential difference of 220 volts and they are connected in parallel. So look at this for example. In AC current we have the line for the live wire, this one live wire, that is the one which is carrying positive terminal, and this is neutral wire, that is negative terminal. So from the electric board's fuse it comes to the electric meter, that is our house, and from the electric meter it is distributed to the circuit board, which gives the connection to the different rooms or the different sockets for different purposes. This three different sockets, and you can see the bigger one that we have, that is for earthing purpose, that is a safety measure, so that when a current has been leaked in some appliance, that earthing wire catches the leaked current and diffuses it into the ground. Okay, so suppose this socket, this wire is broken, but still the live wire and the neutral wire are connected parallel to these two sockets as well, so they will work naturally. So we can just repair this one and we don't have to worry about the breakdown of the whole circuit. Only this portion has to be fixed. This is how the connection in our house has been done. Now remember, we talked about fuse in the previous chapter. So same thing is happening over here. This is the box containing main switch and fuses for each circuit. So for each circuit, this particular connection, there is a fuse over here, and for this one there is a fuse. Okay, so what happens is, if there is a short circuiting and there is overloading, then particular fuse will melt, because fuse works on the principle of heating effect of electric current that we studied in the previous chapter. And why is that? Because what is if sometimes we connect more than one appliances on a particular socket, let's say from this socket we have an extension cable and we have used 2-3 appliances at the same time on this socket, and we are drawing more current. And when we draw more current, we know that when more current is drawn from a conductor, then more heat energy is generated. So what happens is, the heat energy can cause fire hazard. The wiring in our house can catch fire, and to prevent that, we have fuses over here so that not much of the current is drawn, and limited amount of current is drawn so that our appliances and our house is safe from fire hazards. Okay, so it is better to use the limited amount of appliances, and this particular problem is called overloading. When you use so many appliances at the same time on one particular socket, then it causes overloading. It's simple, as the name suggests. The other fire hazard that we have as a problem is short circuiting. I think many of you might have heard about this short circuiting. But what happens is, suppose this socket over here and this live wire and neutral wire, somehow they come in contact with each other. When the live wire and the neutral wire, this positive and negative, in a particular socket or in an appliance, if somehow they come in contact with each other, then a lot of current flows through the circuit. This is called short circuiting, that can make your appliance catch fire, or even your wiring of the house or particular line or a cable can also catch fire. In order to prevent that, once again fuses are used, and nowadays we use what is called MCBs in our house, that is miniature circuit breakers, the switch that goes down when there is high voltage and then you flip it on and then it is back to normal. So same thing, you can use fuse as well and MCBs as well, however it is not mentioned in your textbook. So no need to worry about it, but MCBs and fuses are used. Overloading and short circuiting are the two main fire hazards that we have to think about when we use more appliances. So safety is our main priority, that is your parallel resistance, potential difference for all the appliances, and we don't have to worry about breaking down of one particular appliance or one particular cable when there is a problem. Okay, so short circuiting can also happen if dry wire and neutral wire comes in contact, and overloading when many appliances are connected to one circuit, a lot of current is drawn and it can once again catch fire. So fire hazards are possible due to short circuiting and overloading, and we use fuses for that purpose, which works on the principle of Joule's law of heating that we studied in the previous chapter, heating effect of electric current. I hope it is clear to you students. At our home, for smaller appliances like fans, tube lights and bulbs and everything, we have a normal connection, that is 5 ampere connections, and if a particular home is a one with a large family where we have many ACs or coolers or water heaters like geysers and everything, electric geysers, then we use a separate line for that, that is a 15 ampere line. Okay, so 15 ampere line is connected for heavy appliances and 5 ampere line is connected for smaller appliances. Okay, that concludes our chapter for this particular. Now we will move on to the revision of the chapter from the next video. I hope it is clear to you students, and we will talk more about this in the next video starting from the very beginning. Have a wonderful day.